concrete is made by using what cement, water, fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, and sometimes admixture is added. Okay, so you already know that the admixture are of different types, like retarders, then accelerators, then water entraining, okay, then water detraining, okay, and then superplasticizer. These are the different types of admixtures used in concrete mix design. Okay, so what are the ingredients? So ingredients for making of the concrete are cement, water, fine aggregate, and coarse aggregate, and sometimes we used admixtures. Okay, so before starting, before going to different types of concrete mixes, let us discuss what is a concrete mix design. Okay, so concrete mix design is the determination of the proportion of the concrete ingredients. So and the ingredients are what? It is cement, water, fine aggregate, and coarse aggregate, which is produced. Why we have to do the concrete mix design? Because we are going to determine the suitable portion of these ingredients, that is cement, water, fine aggregate, and coarse aggregate, which will give you or which will produce concrete possessing specified properties such as workability, strength, and durability, okay, with maximum overall economy. So what are the things you have to consider? You have to consider the workability, then the strength, okay, that is when strength means the compressive strength, okay, and the durability. Your concrete you are going to produce should be durable, okay, long lasting, with the maximum overall economy. So while producing this concrete mix design, you also have to look for the overall economy, okay, the process you are going to use and the concrete you are going to make should be economical, okay, high cost should not be incurred in it. So before going to discuss about the methods of concrete mix design, let us discuss what are the different types of concrete mixes available. Okay, so you already know that there are three types of concrete mixes are available. One is your nominal mixes, then another one is your standard mixes. One is your nominal mix, then one is your standard mix, and one is your mix design. Okay, so here we are going to discuss about a mix design, and basically we are going to use the IS code method. Okay, IS code method. So the IS code method we are going to use is what? That is IS 10262 2009. Okay, so basically it was first made in the year 1982, that is IS 10262 1982, which is further reaffirmed many times. So we are going to use the one reaffirmed version, modified version, that is IS 10262, that is 2009. Okay, so you for some cases you also have to take help from the previous IS code, that is IS 10262 1984. Anyway, so what are the for mix design, what are the different codes required? Okay, so you will be requiring IS 10262 2009, obviously that is for concrete mix design. Then you will be requiring IS 456 2000. Okay, so what is the title of this IS code? So code of practice for plain and reinforced concrete. Okay, that is your fourth revision. And then your IS 383-1970. Why IS 383-1970 required? For specification of coarse and fine aggregate, okay, from natural sources for concrete. So for preparation of the concrete, you already know that you will be requiring what? Coarse aggregate and fine aggregate. So for specification of this coarse aggregate and fine aggregate, you will be requiring IS 383-1970. Okay. So basically these three you will be requiring, and some additional IS code you will be also requiring. These are IS 2386 part 3 1963. So what is the title of this code? Method for test of aggregates for concrete. Okay, so what are the tests you are going to perform, like for aggregates? Okay, so when we are going to, when we say aggregate, then it means your fine aggregate and coarse aggregate. What are the tests you are going to do? Suppose your specific gravity of the fine aggregate and coarse aggregate, okay, then water absorption, okay, then moisture content. So these are the tests you are going to perform. So these are the tests that are required for concrete mix design. Okay, so these the tests are available in IS 2386 part 3 1963. Okay, then you will be requiring IS 8112 1989, that is specification for 43 gate ordinary Portland cement. So OPC, you know already that ordinary Portland cement, that is OPC, can be obtained in OPC 43 and OPC 53, like this. Okay, so specification for 43 grade ordinary Portland cement is obtained by IS 8112 1989, and one is your IS 9103 1999. So this gives the specification for admixtures for concrete. So if you are going to use the admixture, so then the IS code IS 9103 1999 will give you the specification for these admixtures. Okay, so now coming to the types of the concrete, different types of the concrete part. So we already know that different types of concrete are what are the types of concrete mixes. So one is your nominal mixes. So what do you mean by nominal mixes? In this nominal mixes, the mixes are fixed. Okay, this cement aggregate ratio is fixed. Okay, in case of your nominal mix, these mixes are fixed, that is your cement aggregate ratio is fixed. Okay, then these offer simplicity and under normal circumstances. So if you are using this for under normal circumstances, then these nominal mixes are used. Okay, have a margin of strength above that specified. So when you are going to use this nominal mix, basically what you are how you are going to prepare it, you are will prepare in such a way that the margin of strength should be above this specified strength. Okay, then your standard mixer. So you already know that the IS code 456-2000, that is the code of practice for plain and reinforced concrete, already has already specified some of the ratios. Okay, for different types of concrete grade. So you already know that M10, M15, M20, M25. So here M is your what? It specifies your mix. Okay, and that 10 is your uniaxial compressive strength after 28 days. Okay, at 28 days, that is in 10 MPa, or it is in for M10 it is 10 MPa, or you can say it is Newton per mm square, 10 Newton per mm square, same thing. MPa and Newton per mm square is same thing. Okay, so IS 456-2000 has already designated fixed mix proportion. Okay, so these are standard mixes for concrete like M10, M15, M20 and M25 to be respectively as 1:3:6. So M5 also there is one ratio, that is 1:5:10. Okay, for M10 it is 1:3:6, then M15 it is 1:2:4, then M20 it is 1:1.5:3, and M25 it is 1:1:2, okay, respectively. So here what is one? This is your cement, that is your fine aggregate, that is your coarse aggregate, that is like this you have the ratios. Okay, so just remember this, these are your standard mixes. For M10 it is 1:3:6, for M15 it is 1:2:4, then for M20 it is 1:1.5:3, and M25 it is your 1:1:2. So the water content, so here it is cement, fine aggregate, coarse aggregate. Okay, so the water content you are going to use, you can take the help from the graph. Okay, what is the water cement ratio we are going to use? So there is one graph between uniaxial compressive strength and water cement ratio. Okay, uniaxial compressive strength after 28 days. Okay, what will be the compressive strength? That is your FCK is given in the y-axis, and the water cement ratio means here your FCK, that is uniaxial compressive strength after 28 days. Okay, or you can say characteristic compressive strength of concrete at 28 days in Newton per. The unit is here, it is MPa. Okay, and here in the x direction you have to plot the water cement ratio. Okay, so suppose for M10, so suppose here your initial compressive strength will be there, M10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and your water cement ratio will be there. So you will have one graph like this. So for its value of, suppose this is your 30, 10, 20, 30. So for 30, you will get one water cement ratio. Based on this, you can calculate the value of your water content. Okay, anyway, so, but you should know that there is no proportion fixed for M30 and above. Okay, hence depending upon the aggregates available and their zoning, type of cement used, which type of cement you are going to like, 43 OPC, 43 OPC, 53 PPC, which type of cement you are going to use. Okay, and the condition of which concrete is to be exposed, we develop, means suppose your concrete is going to be exposed to severe condition or mild condition. Okay, very harsh condition, depending upon this, what we do the mix, we develop mix design for concrete M25, basically we also use for M20 also, and above based on calculations. Okay, so you can consider also M20, because from M20 also we do the mix design, and above based on the calculations in reference to Indian standard code, that is IS 2026-1994, which is further, remember this, so this was first made in that is the first IS code, IS 1026-1984, which was further reaffirmed than the reaffirmed versus, that is IS 1026-2009, which is we are going to use for mixed design, okay, which is further reaffirmed. Anyway, so what is mixed design? So mixed design is the process of selecting suitable ingredients of concrete and determining their relative amounts. Ingredients means, so you have to find out the water content, then you have to find out the cement, okay, cement content, then you have to find out the coarse aggregate, then you have to find out the fine aggregate, okay, and you have also, you have to find out if admixture, any admixture is used, okay. So these are the ingredients of concrete and determining their relative amounts with the objective of producing a concrete of required strength. So the strength required, suppose you have to produce a M20. So for M20 concrete, your characteristic compressive strength will be how much? It is 20 Newton per mm square. So based on this 20 Newton per mm square, you have to do the calculations to find out the ingredients, okay, amount of ingredients, that is water, cement, coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, that is the durability, your concrete should be long lasting, okay, and the workability as economically as possible in termed as the, is termed as the concrete mix design, okay. So basically based on that IS code, that is Indian standard code, that is 1026-2009, what you have to do, you have to do the mix design and find out the ingredients, okay, amount of the ingredients, or that is your water content, cement content, coarse aggregate content, fine aggregate content, and the admixture content. So there are different types of concrete mix design. There are different methods available. One is your American Concrete Institute method, that is ACI method, then your road note number 4 method, then DOE method, then Indian standard method, okay, the IS code method. So here I am going to discuss about the Indian standard method, okay. So for Indian standard method for designing a concrete of desired strength, mixed design, as, or you can say a mixed design as per the IS code 1026-2009, what are the IS code required? Basically these 3 are very much required, okay. IS 1026-2009, obviously for mixed design purpose you will be requiring this, IS 456-2000, so title is Code of Practice for Plain and Reinforced Concrete, okay, you will be requiring this to find out the water cement ratio, based on this how much cement content will be required, what will be the water content based on the exposure condition. This can be get from the table, okay, the different table, that is table 4 and table 5, from this you can calculate, okay. Then IS code 383 and IS code 383-1970, the title is your specification for coarse and fine aggregate for natural sources and concrete, okay. So based on this you are going to define the zone, okay, grading zone of the aggregates. So anyway, first, what are the data requests for mixed proportioning? There are different data you will be requiring. So first, your grade designation. So already I have told you that IS 383-1970 will give you what? Will give you the grading zone of your coarse aggregate and fine aggregate. Okay. So in IS code 383-1970, so gradation of coarse aggregate by sieve analysis is given. Okay. As per IS 383-1973, you are going to use the pans. Okay. Pans, that is of IS sieve sizes of 40 mm, 20 mm, 10 mm, and 4.75 mm, okay. So you are going to place it like this, so 40 mm at top, then 20 mm, then 10 mm, then 4.75 mm, okay. Below this you are going to place the pen, okay. So now what you have to do, you have to put the coarse aggregate at that 40 mm sieve. After that you have to place it in the sieve shaker and have to shake it for around 30 minutes, okay. So coarse aggregate, after that what you from this stage, what you can what are the results you will get? So coarse aggregate, you already know that the coarse aggregates are which retained on 4.75 mm of IS sieves, okay. So if, so after the shaking, if suppose you have taken a sample of 2 kg of sample, okay, or suppose 5 kg of sample you have taken and placed it over the 40 mm of the sieve, after shaking, suppose some amount, okay, suppose 4 kg of the sample has retained on this, retained up to that 4.75 mm. So you already know that when coarse aggregate are those which retained on 4.75 mm of sieve. Okay, so the coarse aggregate size which is greater than 4.75 mm, you know that these are called as coarse aggregate. Okay, so now from here, what you have to do? So pore segregate. Okay, so the workability of the concrete improves it well graded aggregate. Okay, so you already know that well graded. What do you mean by well graded aggregate? Well graded aggregates means that there are different sizes of aggregates are there. Okay, so if the different sizes of means the aggregate sizes are of non-uniform. Okay, so when it is non-uniform, then you can say this is well graded aggregate. Okay, so when you are small size, same size of aggregates, so if the size of the aggregates are uniform, and then it makes concrete harsh and does not work well with the travel. Okay, so you should know that the when the uniformity of the aggregate is not there, or the uniform, okay, when the sizes of the aggregate is ununiform, then you can say that the workability of the concrete improves. Okay, and for fine aggregate, according to that IS 318 1970, you have to use the pan sizes of IS size. What it is? 10 mm, 4.75 mm, 2.36 mm, 1.18 mm, 600 micron, 300 micron, 150 micron, 75 micron. Like this, you have to use. Okay. So basically, this test, that is the sieve analysis test, is given in the IS code 383-1970. So now, these are the this is comes under the data required. So now, after that, the second data required is your type of cement. Okay, which type of cement you are going to use, like OPC 43, OPC 53, which type of cement you are going to use. Okay, then your maximum nominal size of the concrete, then minimum cement content. So these are these things you will get from what you will get from IS 456-2000. Okay, then maximum water cement ratio, then workability, then exposure condition as per IS 456-2000. Okay, table 4 and 5 gives the exposure condition as per IS 456-2000. Okay, then maximum temperature of concrete at the time of placement. Maximum temperature of the concrete at the time of placement or placing. Okay, then the method of placing, by which way, by suppose by hand you are going to place the concrete, or by pumping you are going to use. So these things you have to keep in mind. Okay, so the data requires are, first you will be requiring the grade designation, that is the designation of grade for the coarse aggregate and the fine aggregate. Then you will be requiring the type of the concrete, this should be cement. Okay, type of cement, then OPC 43 grade, OPC 53 grade, which type of cement you will be required. This is your cement. Then maximum nominal size of concrete, then minimum cement content. So these things you will get from IS 456-2000. Okay, then maximum water cement ratio, then workability, exposure condition expert 456-2000. So table 4 and table 5 from IS 456 will give the exposure condition. Okay, whether your concrete is exposed to mild condition, severe condition, very harsh condition, this you can get it from the IS 456-2000. Then maximum temperature of concrete at the time of placing, then early age of strength requirements if required, then types of aggregate. Okay, type of aggregate, then maximum cement content, and then whether type of whether an admixture shall or shall not be used. So if you are going to admixture, which type of admixture you are going to use. So you already know that there are different types of admixtures. For example, you have accelerators, okay, which increase the setting time, then your retarders, like this you have. Okay, so now air entraining admixtures, then super plasticizers. Okay, air water entraining, water detraining admixtures, these are different types of admixtures you have. Okay, and the type of the admixture and the conditions you have, conditions and the condition for which you are going to use. That is already I have told you, the condition means whether you are going to use the accelerator or retarders or air entraining, super plasticizer, which type of admixture you are going to use, that should be required. Okay, data required for mixed proportional. Then you will be requiring the target mean strength. Okay, so what do you mean by the target mean strength? So target mean strength, in order to in order to get the test results not below the characteristic strength. Okay, suppose you are preparing for M25. So after getting the mixed proportion and after making the cube, okay, cube of size 150 into 150 into 150 mm cube, suppose you have placed it under the CTM, or you get the initial compressive strength below 20, then obviously your test results are not proper. So in that case, so there are different causes due to which you may get the less value from that means characteristic, from the characteristic compressive strength. Why? What are the reasons? Because suppose due to the improper proportions, like water, suppose you have to give water as 180 liter, but you have given 170 liter, or suppose you have added 190 liter. So for that, your mean strength, your characteristic compressive strength may change. Okay, for that case, what you have to do in order to get test results not below the characteristic strength, the concrete mix design has to be proportion for higher target mean strength value, and the higher mean strength value, that is we termed it as FCK. That CK is your suffix. Okay, so FCK is equal to FCK plus K into S. So what does this term signifies? That FCK is equal to target mean compressive strength of concrete at 28 days in Newton per mm square or MPa. Then FCK, that what is FCK? Suppose for M25 concrete you have to make, or suppose M30 concrete you have to make, then this 30, that 25 is your FCK. Okay, so characteristic compressive strength of the concrete at 28 days in Newton per mm square, that is MPa. So for 25, that is the compressive strength will be how much? 25 Newton per mm square. Then K is your tolerance factor, and as per IS 456-2000, it is usually taken as 1.65. okay, K is equal to 1.65. So this K value is equal to 1.65. Then standard deviation is equal to S is equal to standard deviation. So suppose for M30 concrete, okay, so the value will be how much? FCK, that is the target mean compressive strength for concrete at 28 days, will be how much? For which concrete you are going to make? So 30 30 for suppose you have to prepare for M30. Okay, so what will be the target mean strength? So 30 plus your K value will be how much? And that is your FCK. Okay, FCK is equal to FCK is equal to this 30 plus your K value, that is your 1.65. okay, and the standard deviation. Okay, so how to calculate this standard deviation? So for this you have to go to the IS 10262. Go to IS 10262. Okay, then from here go to the table 1 of IS 10262. Okay, so this is your table 1. See here, assume standard deviation. So obviously we need what? We need the standard deviation. So standard deviation, how to calculate it? So for M30 concrete, so here I am considering M30. See here, so for M30 concrete, the assumed standard deviation is equal to how much? That is your 5 Newton per mm square. Okay, so now here you have to put how much? 1.65 into 5. Okay, so this is your FCK, and for this FCK you have to prepare accordingly. Okay, so that after if some inaccuracy occurs, you should be ensured that your value comes more than your 30. Okay, more than 30. So anyway, so the value will be how much? 30 plus 1.65, 30 plus 1.65 into 5. Okay, 30 plus 1.65 into 5. So your value will come as 38.25. okay, 38.25 Newton per mm square. Anyway, so now The standard deviation for each grade of concrete shall be calculated separately. Okay, it is calculated based on two factors. So if your test results, okay, field test results are not available, then only you are going to use the table one. Okay, this table you are going to use only when your field data are not available. Okay, but suppose you have prepared concrete concrete samples or concrete cubes. So in that case, your procedure, your standard deviation will be defined. Okay, so standard deviation based on test strength of sample. So in that case, you have to prepare 30 samples. Okay, 30 cubes you have to prepare, and from that you have to find out the standard deviation. Okay, and for here your assumed standard deviation. If the test data are not available, or the, if the sample cannot be prepared, then you have to take it from the table 1 of IS 10262009. Okay, suppose you have to prepare for M10, then your standard deviation will be how much? 3.5. For M20 and M25, your standard deviation will be 4 Newton per mm square. And from M30, M35, 40, 45, 50, 55, your standard deviation will be 55. So these things you can get it from the table 1 of the IS 10262009. Then, but remember this number of test results, okay, the total number of test strength of samples required to constitute an acceptable record for calculation of standard deviation shall not be less than 30. Okay, in that case, when you are going to use the test strength, then in that case your test sample should not be less than 30. Okay, that is recommended in your IS code. Okay, that is recommended in your IS code. See here, 3.2.11, the standard deviation based on test strength, number of test results of samples. Okay, so suppose sometimes what happens, significant changes occurs in concrete. Why? Because suppose, for example, changes in the materials used. Okay, suppose you are using a coarse aggregate from a place, but suppose due to some reasons you are bringing coarse aggregate, or suppose fine aggregate you are bringing from some other place. So obviously the change in the materials, some change in the materials will be there, like your moisture content will change. Okay, so in that case your standard deviation will be different. So from that also you have to do the standard deviation calculations. So anyway, if the data are not available, already if the sample test data are not available, then you can use the standard deviation from this table, that is your IS 10262009. So now I am going to show you one example. Okay, so design mix calculation for M30 concrete. So what are the so design mix calculation for M30 concrete. Okay, so for step by step I will show you how to do it. So first thing you have to write down step one, that is for stipulations for proportioning. Okay, so what are the things you have to stipulate? Okay, so first you have to write down at step one grade designation, that is M30 concrete you have to make. So the type of the cement, OPC 43. Suppose I am using type of the concrete as OPC 43 grade, conforming to IS 8112. Okay, so already I have told you that IS 8112, that is 1989. Okay, IS 8112 1989, which is the specification for 43 grade ordinary Portland cement. Okay, specification for 43 grade ordinary Portland cement, IS 8112 1989. Then your maximum nominal size of the aggregate. Suppose the maximum nominal size of the aggregate I have got it as 20 mm. So these things may change. Okay, 40, 10, these things may change. But in my case, I have considered as 40 mm. Okay. So based on the maximum nominal size of the aggregate, your values of the maximum water content will be changed. Okay. So in my case, I am considering it as how much? 20 mm. Okay, so now go to the table number table number 2 of IS 10262009. Okay, this table you can also find it in the IS 456 and 2000 also. Okay, so now table number 2. So here table number 2, you can see that maximum nominal size of the aggregate I am considering it as how much? It is equal to 20. Okay, so in that case my water cement content, maximum water content will be how much? That is equal to, for maximum nominal size of 20 mm, the water content should be equal to 186. Okay, anyway, so minimum cement content, okay, minimum cement content will be how much? So now you have to find out from the table number 5 of IS code 456 to 2000. Okay, so minimum cement content. So now go to that. This is your IS 456 2000. Go to IS 456 2000. That is your table number 5. You have to go now. So before that, before calculation of this minimum cement content, first you have to check which type of exposure condition is in there and which type of concrete you are going to make. So you already know that 456 and 456 2000, okay, IS code 456 2000 gives the specifications, okay, code of practice, or you can say code of practice for both plain and reinforced concrete. Okay, so here I am going to make the reinforced concrete. Okay, so you already know what is plain concrete and what is reinforced concrete. So here I am making M30 reinforced concrete. Okay, so the values I have to consider, that is the minimum cement content and the maximum water cement ratio I have to consider for reinforced concrete, and the exposure condition I am considering here, it is a severe. Okay, so anyway, let's go to table number 5. So this is your table number 8. So this table number 8, you can also get it in IS 10262 2009. Okay, so now go to the table number 5. Okay, so this is the table number 5. So what is the name of this table? So minimum cement content, maximum water cement ratio, and minimum grade of concrete for different exposure, okay, with normal weight aggregate of 20 mm nominal nominal maximum size. So here I am using the maximum nominal size of 20 mm. Okay, so for 20 mm of nominal size, our values are given for different exposure conditions. Okay, so here I am considering, in my case I am considering the exposure condition is equal to what? Severe condition. Okay, now go to the severe condition. This is your severe condition. Then also I am considering it is a reinforced concrete. Okay, so here these are for plain concrete and this is for reinforced concrete. Now go to reinforced concrete. So in my case your concrete is what? This is our concrete is M30 concrete. Okay, so for severe condition, the reinforced concrete, that minimum cement content is equal to how much? That is equal to 320. 320 is the minimum cement content. See here, that is our exposure condition is severe, and the minimum cement content is equal to how much? That is equal to 320. So just write it down. That is the minimum cement content is equal to 300 kg per meter cube from the table 5 of IS code 456-2000. Okay, then maximum water cement ratio, how to get it? Maximum cement water cement ratio, water cement. Okay, so water cement ratio for M30 concrete is how much? That is equal to 0.41. see here, as we are considering reinforced cement, see here that the maximum water cement, maximum free water cement ratio is equal to, for M30 concrete, it is equal to how much? It is equal to 0.45. okay, so see here, so simply write it down. Maximum water cement ratio is equal to 0.45 from table 5 of IS code 456-2000. Okay, then workability. Suppose we have done the slump test of the concrete and get the slump value of 100 mm. Okay, slump value of 100 mm slump. Then exposure condition, I have already told you this exposure condition, you can also write it at D. Okay, after that you can proceed so that your things will be cleared. Then method of concrete placing. Suppose I have used the pumping method. Okay, I have not used the hand method, manual method. I have used the mechanical method, by that is pumping. Okay, then degree of supervision, good. Okay, then type of aggregate, crust angular aggregate. Okay, so your type of aggregate is crust angular aggregate. Okay, so then it is defined. Okay, then maximum cement content. So here your minimum cement content and the maximum cement content should not exceed 450 kg per meter cube. Okay, as per 456-2000, page number 19. So here you have to go to page number 19. Here it is written. Okay, here it is written. See here, this is your page number 19. See, this is your page number 19, and the clause is 8.2.4.2. Here it is, write down maximum cement content. Okay, cement content not including 5S and ground granulated vast furnace slag. Okay, so in our case we are just using the ordinary Portland cement of 43. Okay, OPC 43 grade. So here your cement content should not exceed 450 kg per meter cube. That is what I have written here. Okay, from the page number 19, clause number 8.2.4.2. And the chemical admixture type, I have used it as super plasticizer. Okay, super plasticizer I am using here. So now at step 2, some of the test data. Okay, before performing the mix design, you have to do some test. Okay, so what are the tests you have to do? You have to already, I have told you at the starting that you have to do some tests like specific gravity, density, then water content, moisture content. These things you have to perform, okay, for cement, then for water absorption for your coarse aggregate and fine aggregate, moisture content for what coarse aggregate, fine aggregate. These things you have to perform, okay. So suppose I have performed this test and got like this, okay. So cement use, first you have to write down cement use, okay. So OPC 43 grade conforming to IS 8112 1989, okay. You can also write down 1989, the year you can also write it down here. Then specific gravity of cement, suppose I have got it as 3.15, okay, 3.15. then chemical admixture, I have used this as super plasticizer conforming to IS 9103. Here you can write down the year 1999, okay. Then specific gravity for coarse aggregate, suppose I have done the test for specific gravity of coarse aggregate and the fine aggregate and got it as 2.74 and 2.74. For both the case of coarse aggregate and fine aggregate, I have got it as 2.74. But these values will be different for different aggregates, okay. Suppose you have taken some aggregates from a from two places. So for both the cases, your specific gravity may be different, or okay, will be different, okay. So suppose I am considering here that I have suppose let us assume that I have performed the specific gravity test for both coarse aggregate and fine aggregate and got it as 2.74, and for fine aggregate also I have got it as 2.74. water absorption for coarse aggregate, I have also performed the test for water absorption test for coarse aggregate and the fine aggregate and got it as 0.5% and 1%, okay. Then free moisture content for more coarse aggregate and the fine aggregate, I have calculated and got it as nil, okay. Moisture content, suppose moisture content I have got it as 0%, okay. Then grading zone, so suppose grading zone I have got it as from sieve analysis and IS code 382/1970 conforming to grading zone 1, that table 4 of IS 382/1970. So here your grading zone is given based on the different percentage retained, okay, percentage retained in the sieve. Based on this you can say that our aggregate is of this grading zone. Aggregate means your fine aggregate and coarse aggregate. So from which IS code you are going to calculate it? From the IS 382/1970, okay. And the table is what? Table 4, okay. And this table you can also find it in the IS code, IS 10262/2009, that is the table number 3, okay. So here also grading zone is given, okay. Grading zone is given, and based on this you have to find out the volume of coarse aggregate per unit volume of total aggregate for different zones of fine aggregate, okay. So in our case, suppose I am considering it as zone 1, zone 1, okay. So now go to the IS 10262. So this is your table 3, and this table you can also find it in the that is the table 4 of IS 382/1970. Okay, so in my case, I am considering it as zone 1. See here, I am considering grading zone as zone 1. Okay, so for zone 1, and the nominal size of the aggregate, I am maximum nominal size of aggregate, I am considering it as how much? I am considering it as, suppose after testing I have got it as 20 mm, okay. So for that purpose my volume of coarse aggregate will be how much? So as it is in zone 1, see here maximum nominal size of aggregate 20, so my volume of coarse aggregate will be how much? 0.60, okay. 0.60. suppose my zone is zone 2, so in that case my value will be how much? 0.62. suppose zone 3, in that case my value will be 0.64. suppose zone 4, in that case my value volume of coarse aggregate will be how much? 0.66, okay. Like this you have to find it out. And the chemical admixture, okay. So grading zone suppose I have got it as zone 1. So now at step 3 you have to find it out the target strength for the mix proportioning. So for getting the target strength, you already know FC is equal to FC plus K into S, okay. So K value you already know, that is equal to 1.65 according to IS 456 2000, and S value, So how to get the S value? You can go to that IS table 8 of IS 456 2000 or IS from the table 1. Okay, from the table 1 of the IS 10262 2009. So in our case, our concrete is what? It is M30. So for M30, our S value, that is the assumed standard deviation, is equal to how much? It is equal to 5. So simply write down 5. Okay, so K value 1.65, S value 5. So your target strength will be how much? 38.25 newton per mm square. Okay, target strength. So after that, at step 4, you have to find out what? You have to find out the selection of water cement ratio. So for reinforced concrete, I have already mentioned above at the step 2, step 1, at the exposure condition, I have taken it as severe and I have considered the M30 concrete as reinforced concrete. Okay, so in that case, for finding out the selection of the water cement ratio, what do I have to do? So for reinforced concrete, considering exposure condition as severe, from table 5 of IS, table 5, okay, now go to table 5, that is your table 4, now go to the table 5. So in our case, our exposure is what? Exposure is severe. Okay, so for severe condition, for reinforced concrete, our maximum free water cement ratio is equal to how much? 0.45. okay, so simply write it down. So maximum water cement ratio 0.45 means your water cement ratio should not exceed more than 0.45. okay, that is your water and cement 0.45 according to what? According to IS 456-2000, okay? It should not exceed 0.45. The place value you can take, okay? So suppose based on experience, I have taken the water cement ratio as 0.42, okay? So as 0.42 is less than 0.45, hence, okay. Okay, you can also take 0.45. So you can take it as based on experience or based on one graph. Already I have told you that we have one graph, that is for water cement ratio with respect to what? With respect to uniaxial compressive strength or characteristic compressive strength of the concrete at 28 days. Okay, in that case, you have to consider what? You have to consider the target strength. Okay, that is 38.25. for 38.25, you have to you can take the water cement ratio. Okay, so if you if you consider this graph, then you will get the water cement ratio as 0.4040. okay, like this you can calculate also, or suppose based on experience, just simply take the value less than that 0.45. okay, so suppose your condition is not here in our case is what? It is severe condition. Okay, so here as it is severe condition, I am taking the water cement ratio for reinforced concrete, I am considering 0.45. suppose the instead of severe condition, suppose the exposure condition is moderate, that in that case water cement ratio should not exceed more than 0.50. okay, these things you have to remember. Or suppose very severe condition, that in that case also yours water cement ratio should not be more than 0.45. and for extreme condition, obviously your water cement ratio should not be more than 0.40. okay, so these things you have to remember. Or suppose plain concrete, suppose for plain concrete you are making, then water cement, for mild condition, your water cement ratio, maximum water cement ratio should not exceed more than 0.60. so these things, so before, you have to check properly the exposure condition and which type of concrete, reinforced concrete, plain concrete, which type of concrete you are going to make. These things you have to check, and based on that condition and the reinforced concrete or plain concrete, you have to find out the water cement ratio. So in my case, my water cement ratio should not exceed more than 0.45, and based on experience, I am taking water cement ratio as 0.42. okay, so as 0.42 is less than 0.45, then hence it is okay. Then after that, you're in your step 5, you have to do what? You have to do the selection of water content. Okay, so from table 2, now you have to go to the table 2 of IS 10262-2009. The slum value, this is your table 2, okay, this is your table 2, maximum water content per cubic meter of concrete for nominal maximum size of aggregate. So in our case, the maximum nominal size is how much? It is equal to 20. And for 20, nominal maximum size of aggregate of 20 mm, maximum water content is equal to how much? That is 186 kg, okay, kg per meter cube, or 186 liter. But the thing is that these values are given for what? You can now go to that column, that is your 4.2, clause number 4.2, selection of water content. See here, the quantity of maximum water per unit volume of concrete may be determined from table 2. Okay, this is the table 2 they are talking about. Okay, the water content in table 2 for angular coarse aggregate. So in our case, the obviously the aggregate I have considering it is angular coarse aggregate. Okay, and for 25 to 50 mm slump drain. So here in this table is for aggregate size of what? Aggregate size of angular coarse aggregate. Okay, angular coarse aggregate and for slump value of how much? For slump value of 25 to 50. But in our case, our slump value is equal to how much? Our slump value is equal to 100. Okay, so where is it? See here, workability slump value is equal to 100 mm. But this table is for what? This table is for slump value of 25 to 50. Okay, so obviously we have to do some modifications. Okay, how to do the modification? So based on the coarse aggregate type and based on the slump value, you have to do this modification. Suppose instead of this angular coarse aggregate, suppose you have subangular aggregates. So in that case, your water content should be reduced by how much? By 10 kg. Okay, so suppose instead of, now here I am considering the coarse aggregate as what? Angular coarse aggregate. Okay, but suppose instead of angular coarse aggregate, I have sub angular aggregate. That in that case, I have to consider the maximum water content is equal to how much? 186 minus 10, that is equal to 176. Or suppose the maximum nominal size of aggregate is, instead of 20 mm, I have 10 mm. That in that case, suppose the coarse aggregate is subangular, then in that case, maximum water content should be equal to how much? 208 minus 10 is equal to 198. Okay, see here, the water estimate from table 2 can be reduced by approximately 10 kg for subangular aggregates, 20 kg for gravel. Okay, instead of this angular coarse aggregate, if you have gravel, then obviously you have to minus it by 20. Okay, 186 minus 20, that is equal to 166 kg you have to consider. And with some crush particles and 25 kg for rounded gravel. So if your gravel is rounded one, and if it does not consisting of crush particles, then you have to reduce by how much kg? You have to reduce it by 25 kg. Okay, so 186 minus 25, that will give you how much? For suppose instead of angular coarse aggregate, suppose if you have rounded gravel with no crush crush material, then in that case your maximum water content should not exceed, maximum water content should be how much? 186 minus 25 kg. Okay, minus 25 kg, then it will give you how much? 151 kg. Okay, then with respect to, so this is with respect to your what type of aggregate. Okay, type of aggregate, and based on the slump value also you have to do some modifications in the water content, maximum water content. Okay, so this value already I have told you, this table is for slump value of how much? 25 to 50. Okay, 50, you can consider 50. Okay, but in my case, my slump value is equal to how much? Slump value is equal to 100 mm. Okay, so for every, so 50 to 100, so value change is how much? 100 minus 50 is equal to 50. So here it is written here, see for the desired workability other than 25 slump, the required water content may be established by trial or by increase by about 3% for every additional 25 mm of slump value. Okay, so 50 to 100, so our slump value is increased by how much? 50 mm. Okay, so 50 mm means two times of 25. Okay, so 25 two times. Okay, so how may the water content, maximum water content, by how much percentage I have to increase? So for every 25, see here, for every 25 mm of slump value increase, I have to increase the water content by 3%. So in my case, the slump value is increased by how much? So 25 to 50, this table is for 25 to 50, you can consider it for 50. Okay, so now in my case it is 100, so increase it by 50. So 25 plus 25, so 3 plus 3, increase percentage will be how much? 3% plus 3%. Okay, that is equal to 6%. Okay, so in 186 I have to increase the water content by how much percentage? 6%. See here, that is what I have written here. Okay, so from the table 2 of IS 10262 for slump value of 25 to 50 mm, okay, here mm range, maximum water content for 20 mm aggregate angular cores is equal to how much? 186 liter. Okay, that is given is equal to 186 liter, maximum size of the aggregate, that is your 20 mm. See here, this is your 20 mm. Now, but in our case, the slump value is 100 mm. As per IS 10262, for every increase in slump value of 25 mm, water content should be increased by 3%. Okay, as in our case, slump value is increased by 50 mm. So already I have told you 100 minus 50. In our case, it is 100, and the table is for 25 to 50. You can consider 50. So obviously, it is increased by how much? In our case, slump value is increased by 100 minus 50. That is equal to 50. So 50. So the water content should be increased by 6%. Okay, so estimated water content for 100 mm slump is equal to how much? So 186, you already get it from table 2. Okay, see, 186 plus 6 by 100 into 186 into 186 liter, or you can say kg per meter cube. Okay, so after calculation, you will get 197 liters. So as now you are using the super plasticizer as a chemical admixture. Okay, so water content can be reduced up 20% and above. So water content you have got it as 197, but as you are using super plasticizer as a chemical admixture, so you can decrease the amount of water content. Okay, suppose based on the trials with super plasticizers, water content reduction of 25% has been achieved. Okay, suppose I have done some trial, and after that I have got that with the when the what super plasticizers are used, water content reduction of 25% has been achieved. So hence the derived water content will be how much? So 197 you have already calculated by doing the interpolation based on these writings, that is the clause 4.2 selection of water content. So now as you are using super plasticizer, then you can reduce the amount of water content. Okay, so suppose 25% water reduction can be achieved. Okay, so 25 means, so water content will be how much? 100 minus 25 is equal to 75. 197 into 75 by 100 liters is equal to, I have got it as 147.75 liters, approximately is equal to 148 liters I have got. Okay, so now this is the water content. Water content is equal to how much? 148 liters. Or how much? How much volume of concrete? 100 meter cube. Volume of concrete, that is what you are going to prepare. Okay, then after that, at step 6, you have to find the calculation of cement content. So how to get the cement content? Water cement ratio, you have taken it as how much? You have taken it as 0.42. okay, or you can also take it from the graph. Already I have told you, that is your UCS versus water content graph. Okay, that you can find it in website, in your Google. Okay, you can Google it and get it. Water cement ratio is equal to 4:2. Okay, so you have already calculated the amount of the water. So water by cement is equal to how much? Is equal to 0.42. water by cement is equal to 0.42. so now simply put the value of your what? Put the value of your water content, that is equal to 148, and 0.42 bring here and see, bring here. So this will give you what? 148 by 0.42 will give you the cement content, that is your C. Okay, so after calculation, I have got it as 352.38 kg per meter cube. I have taken it as 353 kg per meter cube. Okay, so from table 5 of IS 456, maximum cement content for severe exposure conditions is equal to how much? 320 kg per meter cube. Now go to table 5, you have to check, obviously. So your condition is what? Severe condition. For severe condition, for reinforced concrete, your minimum cement content should be equal to how much? Minimum cement content should be equal to 320 kg per meter cube. Okay, the minimum cement content for severe exposure condition should be equal to 300 kg per meter cube. But in our case, the value is equal to how much? 353 kg per meter cube. So obviously 353 kg per meter cube is greater than 320 kg per meter cube. So hence, okay. Okay, so now it is okay. Suppose, but after calculation, you have got it as 300 instead of 353, you have got it as 3. Suppose, for example, you have got it as 305 kg per meter cube. For example, okay, then in that case, what you'll have to do? You have to take it. So you know that 305 is obviously less than 320 kg per meter cube. Though in that case, your cement content should be is equal to how much? Cement content should be is equal to 320. Okay, because according to that IS code, it is already written for reinforced concrete in severe condition, the minimum cement content should not be less than 320. Okay, so in that case, you have to take it as 320 kg per meter cube. If after calculation you have got it as cement content is equal to 305, or suppose 315, or suppose 317, like this, if you have got. Okay, but in our case, now in our case, these values are what? And this value is equal to 353 kg per meter cube, which is greater than your 320. So in that case, we will take the maximum value. That is our 353 kg per meter cube. Clear? So now what are the things you have calculated? You already know for preparation of the concrete, you will be needing what? You'll be needing water. You'll be needing cement. So water, and this is your what cement content you have calculated. This is your water content you have calculated. So now you have to find out what? You have to find out the amount of your admixture, that is your super plasticizer which you have used, then your coarse aggregate and fine aggregate. Okay, so now at step 7, we are going to use what? We are going to do the proportion of volume of coarse aggregate and we are going to find out the proportion of volume of coarse aggregate and fine aggregate. Okay, so from table 3, now go to the table 3 of IS 10262-2009. Volume of coarse aggregate corresponding to 20 mm size of aggregate and fine aggregate zone 1 for water content ratio of 0.50. Okay, so for this, remember, okay, here this table, this table 3, volume of coarse aggregate per unit volume of total aggregate for different zones of fine aggregate, it is given here. So in our case, I have considered this zone is equal to how much? Zone 1, okay? That for zone 1, for maximum nominal size of aggregate, that is what I have written at this step 1, is equal to how much? Is equal to 20 mm. The zone 1, the coarse aggregate, volume of coarse aggregate is equal to how much? 0.60. 0.60, okay. See here, that is 0.60, okay. But this table is for what? This table is for water cement ratio of, it is written in the 4.4, okay, water cement ratio of 0.5. This table is for water cement ratio of 0.5. When water cement ratio is 0.5, then only you can use this value of 0.60. But in our case, the water cement ratio is equal to how much? When it is 0.50, then only the value is equal to 0.60. But in the present case, in our case, the water cement ratio is 0.42. Therefore, the volume of coarse aggregate is required to be increased and decreased in the volume of fine aggregate. Okay, so as the water cement ratio is decreased, so what we'll have to do? We have to increase the amount of volume of coarse aggregate and decrease the amount of fine aggregate. Okay, remember this. Okay. So when water cement, so here I have written down, when water cement ratio is lowered by 0.05, volume of coarse aggregate is increased by what? Volume of coarse aggregate is increased by 0.01, okay? So in our case, the water cement ratio is equal to how much? 0.42. But the table is for water ratio is equal to how much? 0.5. So decrease by how much? In our case, the water cement ratio is decreased by how much? 0.50 minus 0.42. That is equal to 0.08. Okay, so now when our water cement ratio is lowered by 0.05, then the volume of coarse aggregate is increased by how much? 0.01. okay, but in our case, it is lowered by how much? 0.08. okay, for decrease in water cement ratio of 0.05, coarse aggregate volume is increased by how much? 0.01. then for decrease in water cement ratio by 0.08, in our case, because it is 0.08, coarse aggregate volume to be increased by how much? 0.01 divided by 0.05 into 0.08. It will give you how much? 0.016. Okay. So therefore, corrected volume of coarse aggregate for water cement ratio should be is equal to how much? So at 0.5, it is equal to 0.60. And the corrected or adjustment value is equal to how much? 0.16. And you already know that the coarse aggregate value is to be increased. So 0.6 plus 0.016, it will give you 0.616. Okay, 0.60 plus 016 is equal to 0.616. Okay, then again you are not using the hand method for placing. Okay, you are using the pumpable concrete, so your water contents can be reduced by what? Water your volume of coarse aggregate can be reduced by 10%. Okay, it is written in IS 10262 2009. Okay, so from this is your volume of what? This is your volume of coarse aggregate, so decrease it by 10%, that is your 0. So volume of coarse aggregate will be how much? 0.616 into 0.9 is, it will give you 0.5544. okay, so that is the volume of coarse aggregate. Okay, so now based on this table 3, you have calculated the volume of coarse aggregate. Okay, so volume of coarse aggregate, so this table is for what? Volume of coarse aggregate per unit volume of total aggregate. So total aggregate is how much? Total aggregate is equal to 1 meter cube. Total aggregate is equal to 1 meter cube, and you have calculated the volume of coarse aggregate. So now from 1, if you minus the volume of total aggregate, obviously you know that total aggregate comprises of coarse aggregate and fine aggregate. You have find out the volume of what? Coarse aggregate. So now total aggregate means 1. So if from 1, if you minus the 0.5544, that is the volume of coarse aggregate, you will get the volume of fine aggregate. That is the volume you have calculated, that is 0.5544, 0.4456. okay, so now up to this you have calculated only the volume. Okay, but you have to find out the amount, how much kg per meter cube, how much kg of coarse aggregate and fine aggregate will be required for preparation of 1 meter cube of concrete. You have to find it out. Okay, so now how to calculate it? So now mix calculation, the mix calculations per unit volume of concrete shall be as follows. Okay, mix calculations. Okay, so volume of concrete you have to prepare is equal to how much? 1 meter cube. So volume of cement is equal to how much? So weight of cement you have already calculated, mass of cement you have already calculated, that is equal to 353 mass of cement divided by specific gravity of cement. So specific gravity of cement in this step 2 I have written on specific gravity of cement is equal to how much? 3.15. okay, so in your exam, when you are going to do in your exam, these values, okay, the datas at the step 2 will be given. Okay, but when you are when you will be working as a site engineer or a field engineer, okay, then you have to find it out. Okay, before doing the mix design, you have to perform all the tests like specific gravity of cement, specific gravity of coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, water absorption value, moisture content. These things you have to find it out, okay, in the field before performing the mix design. But in your exam, these values, that is this step 2 values will be given. Okay, and different exposure conditions will be given. So volume of concrete is equal to mass of cement divided by specific gravity of cement. So mass of cement you have already calculated, that is equal to 353. So where you have calculated mass of cement? 353, if you remember, at this step 6. Okay, at this step 6 you have already calculated this 353. See, calculation of cement content. Okay, 353. So simply put the value, 353 divided by specific gravity of cement is equal to 3.15 into 1/1000. okay, put it in the formula and you will get the volume of cement is equal to 0.12 meter cube. Similarly, find out the volume of water. So volume of water is equal to mass of water. Mass of water you have also calculated in step number what? Step number 5. Step number 5 you have calculated selection of water content. Go to step number 5. So the water you have calculated is how much? 148 liters. Okay, simply put the value, 148, specific gravity of water you already know, that is 1 into 1/1000, you will get how much? 0.148 meter cube. So volume of, so now up to this you have calculated the volume of everything. Okay, volume of in only you are left with the volume of chemical admixture you have not calculated, but you have calculated the volume of what? Coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, fine aggregate you have calculated here. That is the volume of coarse aggregate, that is the volume of fine aggregate, that is the volume of cement, and this is the volume of water you have calculated. Now in this next step you are going to calculate what? You are going to calculate the volume of admixture. Okay, chemical admixture super plasticizer, that is the 2% by mass of the cementitious material. Here I am using what? 2% by mass of cementitious material. So cementitious material is what? Cement, okay? So to tell mass of the chemical admixture is how much? 2% of the cementitious material. So cement is equal to how much? 353, you have already calculated, into 2/100. So it will give you what? It will give you mass of chemical admixture divided by specific gravity of admixture, that will be written along with the bag of the admixture, or the, if it is in liquid form, it will be written at the bottle, okay? That is the specific gravity of the admixture will be written. So from that you can use, so it is equal to 1.145 for the super plasticizer I am using. For that, the specific gravity is equal to how much? 1.145 into 1/1000 is equal to 0.00617. After calculation, I have got it as 0.00617 meter cube. Okay. So now you have calculated everything. So volume of all in aggregate is equal to how much? So A. So this is A is your volume of concrete. So total volume of concrete, A minus B plus C plus D. So B is your what? What is B? B is your cement water content, C is your cement content, D is your admixture content. Okay. So from one, if you minus these three, then you will get obviously volume of aggregate, total aggregate. So volume of total aggregate, 1 minus 0.112 plus 0.148 plus 0.00617. That is the admixture content. That is your 0.148. That is your what? That is your water content. And 0.112, that is your cement volume. Okay. So you will get the volume as is equal to how much? 0.73383. Okay. Then mass of, now after that you have to find out the mass of coarse aggregate. Okay. Mass of coarse aggregate, how to find it out? So E, that is the E value. That is your 7.3383 E into volume of coarse aggregate. Volume of coarse aggregate you have already find out in the step 7. That is your 0.5544 into specific gravity of coarse aggregate. Specific gravity of coarse aggregate, I have got it as after laboratory test, I have got it as 2.474. That is in step 2, I have already written. See, specific gravity of coarse aggregate 2.74 and specific gravity of fine aggregate 2.74. Okay, so now as we are calculating this volume of coarse aggregate, mass of coarse aggregate, then I am using the specific gravity of coarse aggregate. Okay, so 0.73383, that is your E value, this E value, into volume of coarse aggregate, that is your 0.5544, then your specific gravity of coarse aggregate, Ca means coarse aggregate. Okay, 2.74 into 1000 kg. Okay, so ultimately I will get 1114.73 kg. Okay, so now I have got what? I have got the mass of coarse aggregate, mass of cement, mass of water, mass of admixture. Okay, mass of admixure is equal to how much? 353 into 2/100. Okay, and mass of fine aggregate is equal to E into volume of fine aggregate into, this is into, okay, into specific gravity of fine aggregate into 1000. So 0.73383 into 0.4456 into 2.74 into 1000 kg, I have got it as, after calculation I have got it as 895.96. so volume of fine aggregate is equal to 0.4456. so how to get this? 1 minus 0.5544. so what is 0.5544? it is your volume of coarse aggregate. Okay, so total volume from the table 3, you have already know that total volume is equal to 1 meter cube, aggregate is equal to 1 meter cube. So if from 1, if you minus the coarse aggregate, you will get the fine aggregate. So after that I have got it as 0.4456. okay, so this is the, so after that you have also calculated the mass of the fine aggregate. After that, at step 9, mix proportion of trial, just simply put it down. So cement content you have got it as 353 kg, water content you have got it as 148 kg per meter cube, fine aggregate you have got it as how much? 895.96. coarse aggregate you have got it as 1114.73 kg. and also you can write it down, admixture content, that is equal to how much? So simply write it down, 353 into 2/100. After that, suppose, just wait, your aggregate amount, mass of aggregate, you can also write it down, 353 into 2 divided by 100. Okay, so it will give you 7.06 kg per meter cube. 7.06 kg. okay, aggregate you can also write it down, 7.06 kg. okay, simply write it down like this. Here also I forget to write it down, but these things you also have to write it down. Okay, here After that, what will have to do at step 10? Two more trials, okay? Two more trials. So this is your first trial, okay? Trial number one you have got. This is your trial number one. Now for second trial and third trial, you have to perform, okay? How to perform this? In that case, you have to do the variation of plus minus 10% of water cement ratio. So in our case, our water cement ratio is equal to how much? 0.42, okay? So plus minus 10% variation you have to do. Now water cement ratio you have to take it as 0.32 and 0.52, okay? You have to take it down and you have to find it out the characteristic compressive strength in both the cases. For 0.42 water ratio, 0.32 water ratio and 0.52 water ratio, you have to find the characteristic compressive strength. And after that, what you'll have to do, you have to plot the data, okay? For every cube, obviously you are going to do test for suppose 3 cube. For 0.42, you have suppose got the value for T cube, 3 cubes, okay? The characteristics say here you have to put the UCS, here you have to put the water cement ratio. For 0.42, suppose you have got like this, 3 values. Like this line you have got for, this is for suppose 0.42. For 0.32, suppose you have got like this. For 0.52, suppose you have got like this. So from this graph, you have to find out a suitable equation, okay? Suitable equations from this equation, or suppose a suitable graph, you have to find it out, and based on this, for target mean strength, that is your for 30, that is equal 38.25, you can find out the water cement ratio, and based on this you can do the calculation for get the mix proportions, okay? So here that is what I have written, two more trials having variations of plus minus 10% of water cement ratio is carried out, and a graph between three water cement ratio and their corresponding strength, that is your UCS, okay? Obviously you are going to place it in the cube, that is of size 150 mm into 150 mm, and after that, after curing it at 7 days, at 21 days, at 28 days, you have to find out the compressive strength, okay? After 28 days, what you'll have to do at 28 days, this is your cube, you have to place this in the CTM, okay? So in CTM you have two plates. One plate is at below, and at this one is movable, and this one is fixed, okay? So obviously you have to apply pressure here. So force per unit area will give you what? You will get the characteristic compressive strength, okay? So compressive strength you will get, and this compressive strength at 0.42, 0.32, 0.52, you have to plot, and a suitable graph you have to plot, okay? And with respect to that, water cement ratio and their corresponding strength shall be plotted to work out the mean proportion for given target strength for field trials, so that durability requirement shall be met, okay? So for 38 from this graph, for 38.25 from this graph, you are going to get, what you will have to do, you will have to find out the water cement ratio, and you have to do the calculation based on this. So like that you can do the calculation. So in your IS 10262, one calculation is also available for M40 concrete, okay? And also one example is given for using concrete which is made up of fly ash, okay? So these things, you go through this. So these are same method. So I have showed you how to do it for M30 concrete. So for M40 concrete, it is given, okay, different criteria and different considerations they have taken here. So same thing, you just go through it, you will be able to understand it. And one example, if example mixed proportion M40 using fly ash, okay, using fly ash is in here. So for fly ash, the calculations will be different, little bit different. Obviously, you have to check the different, what are the things you have to keep in mind. Suppose the placing, okay, whether you are placing it by hand or whether you are using the pumping method. So if you are using that the 10% decrease you should not have to do, okay? So these things you have to keep in mind. Suppose your batching has been changed, so in that case, how your standard deviation will be changed, these things you have to keep in mind. Clear? So like this, you have to find it out. Thank you.